The weather's been relentless. Floods, a cyclone, the rain cutting the north off, and there's been a tornado in Waihi Beach. But the Kiwi spirit is relentless too. Tonight we're in Wairoa, Hawke's Bay, where locals have been working hard on the cleanup. But even with their Herculean efforts, there's much left to do. So we're alongside one iwi group who hit the road to support their whanaunga nearly 8 hours away.
When disaster strikes.
That's the river, it's that high.
It was rolling and you could hear it. It was roaring. You could actually hear it.
Is when you most need whānau.
You've lost everything.
Yeah.
And you're okay. Are you insured?
No, unfortunately. Yeah.
Oh, unfortunately, you know.
To share the stories.
What were you yelling?
The river's coming, it's breached. And I was just beeping my horn just constantly.
And the load.
Do you even know Hayden and his crew?
No, I've never met them before.
They just turned up here and...
Yeah, they just turned up, introduced themselves and said, look, we've just come to give a hand.
The people who'll come, no matter what.
Hey, that's just aroha, that's all that is.
It's 5:15 a.m. in Dannyberg. Nannies, uncles, cousins, the whānau gathers.
Big day today, heading up to support our whānau in Wairoa.
There's a big trip ahead, and a worrying one.
Be safe while you're there, and do the mahi you're sent down to do.
These trained first responders, all volunteers, are hitting the long road to Wairoa.
How would you describe what we're going into?
It's unknown, really, in Wairoa. We've got whānau in there, and they always talk it down because that's how they are.
Some people have described it as being like a war zone.
Yep. You got a copy there, Kahu One?
Hayden Hape is chair of Tāmaki Nui Arua of iwi Ngāti Kahungunu. In his convoy of five vehicles are 20 volunteers.
Harrison Kenotoku Ingwa.
My name's Jerome Crawford.
I'm Claudia Happy.
Alicia Wright.
Tēnā koutou, ko Donna Henare Taku Ingwa.
They're leaving their own families and jobs behind, ready to dig in.
And how long is this trip going to be?
7.5.
And that's because the roads are closed?
Yep.
7.5 hours, a trip that would normally only take 2.5, forced to take the long way.
How long are you going to be up there for?
Starting with 3 days, but if we have to push it out to five or, you know, more, then we will.
We stop in Taupō for supplies.
Just getting our stores for us for the duration of our stay so we're not taxing the resources from the whānau in Wairoa.
Yeah.
Jerome and mum Alicia are from Wairoa. It'll be their first time back since the cyclone.
How are you feeling about going in there?
Apprehensive, emotional. It's hard knowing that they're all struggling.
The stories waiting at the other end are grim. People like Hidini McElroy.
Well, I can handle starting again.
You can handle starting again?
Yep.
You're going to have to start again from scratch?
Yep. It's going to be long, but, you know, one bit at a time, eh?
Were you able to save anything?
No.
Stories like this are echoing across the East Coast. In Petane, Napier, people like Fire Rose Hiha, whose marae is now cut off by mountains of mud and logs.
This is the worst that I've ever seen it.
Their once peaceful urupā, now under metres of silt.
Your parents are in here?
And my parents and my sister, all my whānau.
Oh.
So it's quite devastating to see.
Yeah.
And over in Waiohiki, incredible escape stories like young Albies, who had to jump on his roof.
So how high did the water get to?
I was pretty close to the roof. We're up there for about 2 hours, 3 hours.
Holy shots, boys.
And then, yeah, once it was sort of by the roof, sort of started thinking about what we're going to do next if it hit the roof, and panic mode a little bit.
With intermittent comms and desperate pressure on first responders, many like Albie were on their own. Hayden Hape says what will help is having more Māori on emergency planning and response groups.
Are those local and central authorities equipped to look after Māori?
No, not at all.
And why is that?
Because we actually have the ability to do it,
yeah.
Māori, you know. We do it all the time. Someone could pass away suddenly in our whānau, in our community, and boom, all of a sudden we're catering for 200 people, and communication is the big thing, which we have.
Māori magic.
Aye.
The networks activate.
Yeah, that's the one.
Finally, after nearly 8 hours, our convoy arrives in Wairoa.
How are you feeling, Jerome?
That's shocking.
Mum Alicia is feeling it too.
Pretty disheartening. Just the mess, the hardships our whānau have to go through.
And that's after a week of clean-up. Wairoa has already been hard at work.
So this is beautiful Takitimu Marae. Hard to believe that just a week ago this was all under silt.
Yes.
Wairoa kuia, wiki hauraki.
All our whānau did it by hand.
Oh, that's amazing.
You
must be pretty proud.
Oh, there's no words to describe how proud we are of them all.
Wairoa whānau, many of them young, got to work stopping only to welcome the mayor, using their brooms and shovels as taiaha.
Do you want me to press it?
Yeah.
What they've achieved can only be truly appreciated when you see this.
There's the river.
Roads, front yards, the marae, all a muddy lake.
We just saw this almighty amount of water coming.
What did it look like?
It was rolling and you could hear it. It was roaring.
Ooh.
You could actually hear it.
Just 30 minutes earlier, Wiki's whānau were asleep. They were woken by a neighbour.
She was saying, Wiki, Wiki, get out, get out. Get out, everybody's got to get out.
I'd gone to Wiki's place. I drove into her driveway and just banged on their windows.
Michelle McElroy was that neighbour. With her own home flooded, she rushed out to warn others.
I couldn't bear the thought of losing our people.
But her own yellow-stickered home, says husband Hirini, may not be salvageable.
You've lost everything.
Yeah.
And you're okay. Are you insured?
No, unfortunately. Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, Hirini.
You know. Oh, it's okay. It's, you know, material things. Yep, that's the way it is.
You got your lives.
Yeah, got our lives. Yeah.
We just met a whānau around the corner, the uninsured.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, we've banged into two of them this morning. So, we're just going to get in and help them as much as we can.
Because the ideal is that they don't get red sick at eh?
Yeah, correct.
The Tāmaki Nui Arua whānau are in full swing, working to save homes. But humbled by the Wairoa whanaunga, they've come to help.
The manaakitanga that we've received since we've been here from our Wairoa whānau has been mean. They welcomed us with open arms and gave us kai and then gave us about, 19 homes to go and check on and see if they need help. And But a lot of the whānau have done an amazing job already, you know.
Yeah.
They're too much, our Wairoa people.
It's been a long, hard journey from Dannevirke to Wairoa. But for the Ngāti Kahungunu ki Tāmaki Nui Arua whānau, it's just what family do.
Come here to tautoko the whānau.
Kei konei au ki te manaaki, ki te awhina I a mātou tangata.
It's a great feeling to be able to do something for this community.
I'm just here because, you know, I feel for these people and we've come up to Wairoa to help our whānau in need.
Even as the weather again starts to take a turn for the worse.
Are they worried? Are you worried?
Nah, we're not worried. Head down, ass up.
Cool. Well, as you know, the weather did kick back in, but of course whānau and locals are working through. We want to mihi to all volunteers across the country who've been working so hard. Kei te mihi aroha. Kia koutou.